Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you the best and quickest way to take multiple sheets in Excel or workbooks and combine them into one sheet. We're going to go through this step by step. This is going to save you a lot of time. Let's get started right away. If you want to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link to this down below in the description so you can download these files and follow along with me. So first of all, let's take these four sheets that I have of these different sales numbers, and there's about 80 in total entries here, and we're going to bring them all together into one. Now, first of all, I'm going to go to File, and I'm going to create a blank workbook to bring this into. Now, the first step, we're going to go up to Data here, and we're going to go get that data from a file, and it's going to be from an Excel workbook. Those four sheets are in one workbook. So I'm going to select this. And where do I have it saved? Well, I just have it on my desktop in this folder here, and this is the file. I'm going to import this in. When this loads up, you can see the four tables that are here. And if I click on each one, you can get a preview. I want to bring them all in. I'm going to just select one of these, and I'm going to show you how to make sure that you're working with all of them. So once you have one of them selected, go down to here and click Transform Data. This is where you're going to start to shape how things look. You'll notice then that the Power Query Editor opens up. If I look up at the top, it says eSales. That's because that's the one I had selected, but I want to have everything. So the first step is going to be is to go back in my applied steps to the source. And one thing nice about the Power Query Editor, every time I do something, it applies a step, but we can hit the X and go backwards. So when I go back to the source here, I see I have the different sales here. I have North, South, West, and East. Now, I don't need all these columns right here, so I'm going to go ahead and delete some. I could just right-click and select multiple or remove, or I could go up and choose a column. And this allows me, if I had lots, I could unselect and just pick the ones I want and hit OK. So now I'm down to two. But within the data, there's more there. I just have to expand it. So if I click the expand, here are all the columns inside that data, and I'm just going to hit OK. Now, if I just scroll across, you can see all the information is across in the columns. And if I scroll down, north, south, west, east. But I need to clean some things up here. Notice I have some null, some empty blank ones. I don't want them. I have date in here. And I don't want these headers across to be called just data column two. A quick way to change this is to just click right here, use first row as headers. When I do that, notice now it just kind of copied those all up. And you can make some quick changes, because in this case, I don't want it to be North Sales. So I'm just going to double click in here, and I'll just type all sales for this example. The next thing I want to clean up is I can filter out. So in this column right here, I pointed out the null and the date. We can go up to the filters and choose uncheck what we don't want. So I don't want the null in there. And I don't want that date in there because every time I bring in a new entry, that's the top header and I don't want that. I'm going to hit OK. So that's at the top of each table. Now, if I look at this, if I go down, you should see that I have 80 entries and I've cleaned this up. If you want to learn more about the Power Query Editor, I have a more detailed tutorial about that. I'll put the link right up and above in the card and down below in the description. So this is clean enough for what I want. I kind of have my 80 entries. I'm going to go up to the top left-hand corner right here and just click Close and Load. So here's the data inside that Excel spreadsheet. It's on eSales. I could change this if I want, so I just have to double click. And again, I could put all sales in here. If I scroll down, we have South, we have West, East, all in one. So it took all those and combined it. And that was a very quick way to do it. If I look over at the query over here, it says 80 rows loaded. If I double click on this, it actually opens back up into the Power Query Editor. But again, check out my other tutorial about that. But what happens if we get more data? Let me show you how we can refresh this and this will update. Now I'm just back in the original file that I showed you at the very beginning that we merged all these from. So let's say in North Sales, I'm gonna go and just copy some of these down. So I'm just gonna copy about four more entries and put it in. I'm gonna go ahead and hit save now. When I just move back to the other sheet that we have opened right here, it's still at 80, notice, but if I go back to it, right click and hit refresh, look now, it says 85. And we can do this with just adding another sheet as well. So let's say now we want to combine the data of four different workbooks into one. The process is very similar, but before we start doing this, I just want to point out with these different workbooks, and I have them open right here, you need to make sure that the schema is set up the same. So you need consistent column headers, data types, and number of columns. You can have the columns in different orders, but they have to be named the same. Make sure that your tabs down below all have the same name as well. So you could run into problems if there's some different names on each of these. Let's go ahead and open a blank Excel workbook. Inside my blank workbook, I'm going to go back to my data tab here, go to get data from file. I'm not going to go from workbook this time. I'm going to go from folder. When this opens up, I select the folder that contains my workbooks. Make sure in that folder you only keep the workbooks that you're using. Don't add other things into it. I'm just going to click open, and now it shows me the different files that are in there. So you can see there's east, sales, north, south, and west. To keep things simple this time, I'm just going to go to combine down below, combine and load. So this is going to load those four things up into this sheet that we had before. I just have to select sales and then I go ahead and hit OK. This brings it into my workbook here. The query is created. And if I scroll down, you can see that all the information, I have all my entries in it. So what happens if things get updated and you need to add another sheet? So we have four. So this is connected to that regions folder. If I go and grab this and just drop it in here, so now I have this central sales in here and everything is set up in that one the same. If I just go to here again, under data, you'll see that there is a refresh all. And if I refresh it, it went from 80 to 100 rows. So just like that, I could add another workbook, but making sure that the schema is the same, it will pick that up when you refresh it and you have all that data inside this one sheet as well. I hope these two methods that I showed you will work smoothly and quickly for you. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.